Hi, Simba. You're going to take a big stinky poop now, aren't you?
Yes.
Yeah, he is. More of a buttercup. Well, she's not a redhead.
Apparently, I look like Colonel Sanders.
Well, there's weird out the entire audience tonight.
Yeah, we'll just have a creepy... There's right there.
Yeah.
I'm keeping the glasses because I tried to do the makeup and it came out awful.
All right. So
we're just doing it. Because I was like, I might need to take off the glasses. I should try to do the makeup. And it's a hot mess under here. So,
Grady, what are you doing back there, buddy? He's just a weird cat. Okay, so first off, before we get to the other part, it is it's time for the what the fuck is wrong with you? Where is my intro? Just everything is broken and not working right, so I'm wearing the right costume for it. We are, if it's a Fallout costume, nothing works right here. Perfect. That's perfect. It's Bethesda all the way. Let's see. I was telling everybody I was going to offering a new service here. It's called Radio Dead Air First, and it will involve for $100 a year, you'll get your own private server on Radio Dead Air, which means I will come to your house every week for 5 hours and annoy you in person.
I won't.
All right, here we go. Intro. Each week, Catherine. Radio Dead Air audience, go out in the worldwide interwebs, find all sorts of horrible stuff. Right back here for a little segment we like to call What the Fuck is Wrong with You? My camera's off shot because I was pointing at the cat. Stupid me. Let's start off. Not a lot of Halloween-y stuff this year, but I'm sure we'll have some next week. However, we do have someone who likes to dress up in costume. It just didn't quite work out the way he was expecting it to. This is some this is man impersonating officer pulls over van full of cops.
Oh no. Oh honey.
Oh yes. Hicksville, New York. According to the According to the Nassau County Police Department, a Hicksville man was arrested for criminal impersonation last week. Detectives say that a 25-year-old Valerie Portlock of Gerald Avenue was traveling on Hicksville Road in a black Nissan Sentra when he activated his air horn and emergency lights built into his car and attempted to pull over a van. Turns out the van was occupied by Nassau County electronic squad detectives. The detectives, while stopped in traffic, identified themselves, then approached Portlock's vehicle. Portlock fled the scene, swerved into oncoming traffic, and refused to stop. He continued to drive at a high rate of speed onto the Long Island Expressway.
I'm not sure I buy that.
Oh, really?
The Long Island Expressway? I mean, it depends on what time of day it was. Because there are certain times of day where there's no high rate of speed.
Yeah, that's just not
an option. Expressway.
That's just not an option. He's charged with first-degree criminal impersonation, second-degree reckless endangerment, unlawfully fleeing from police. I bet he thought he was so slick.
Yeah.
Look, I got the lights built into my car. I got the siren. They'll never know.
It's funny because I have a cousin who's a Nassau County cop.
Oh.
Because I'm Irish, so of course I do.
You need to ask him about this.
I know. I got to ask him about it because I'm sure he's heard the story. Like, even if this isn't his beat, I'm sure he's heard about it.
Of all the cars he picked to pull over.
That's just bad luck.
Of all of them. I think you need to turn me down a little. I'm echoing a bit.
I thought that was just part of the costume.
No. No, I'm hearing myself in your speakers.
Oh.
You need to turn my volume down a little.
Is that better?
Yeah, I think that'll work better. Okay. So yeah, that's
vision in these glasses. I got like 80%.
Good enough.
Yeah.
So it just that completely fucked up.
Yeah. I don't know why people like to pretend to be cops and pull people over. I don't know why this is a thing. Well, like, who the fuck do you think you're fooling? I get it when rapists do it.
Yeah.
If just, you're not looking to take someone to a secluded place and murder them, is it what's just, your goal?
Is it just like a fetish to like give people, I'm going to let you off with a warning this time, and then yeah. you go home and jerk off furiously? Is that how it works?
What's the goal?
I know.
Dan, apparently everybody thought you were Colonel Sanders. It's not that kind of tie.
He doesn't have a bolo. He says,
yeah, I did think about having us go as like evil Colonel Sanders and evil Wendy.
Well, let's I'm still hearing myself. You got to turn the volume the mic down. It's the microphone's picking up the speakers. You need to turn the speakers down. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. All right. Yeah, speaking of furiously jerking off, this is not a good story. This is a terrible story.
I don't like any story that starts with speaking of furiously jerking off.
Oh dear.
It's not designed to make me feel good.
Well, no, nothing that happens on this is about making people feel good. This is horrible. What we do is horrible. Man had sex with stuffed animals at Target.
Yeah.
The deep sigh. Florida man yesterday sexually assaulted a pair of large stuffed animal toys inside a Target store. As identified in a criminal complaint, Cody Christopher Meter, 20, entered the retailer around 2 p.m. Tuesday and approached a display of merchandising featuring characters from the Disney film Frozen. Meter, seen it right, selected a large Olaf stuffed animal and proceeded to place it on the floor of the Target in Pinellas Park. He then began to dry hump the cinematic snowman until he ejaculated on the merchandise.
Oh.
Okay.
Wow.
Correct me if I'm wrong. Dry humping, by definition, is above the clothes action.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So how the fuck did he ejaculate on Olaf?
Got so excited.
Like, does this guy just come cups at a time?
God only knows. Meter returned the soiled Olaf back to the display before entering the toy department, where he selected a large unicorn stuffed animal and began to dry hump this item. After consorting with the stuffed animals, Meter, who lives in St. Petersburg, was detained while still inside the store. After being read his rights, Meter reportedly admitted to doing stupid stuff and admitted he had, quote, nutted on the Olaf stuffed animal. The stuffed items, cops say, were removed from the store floor and destroyed.
When Olaf says he likes warm hugs, that's not what he means. It's not a euphemism. He just likes hugs.
Okay, I'm going to back up. Cody.
Do you wanna fuck a snowman? I can't read who it is because I can't read the orange text. Sorry.
Oh. Okay, Cody. Can we back up just a second? Doing stupid stuff.
Yeah.
I've done stupid stuff. I've done donuts on someone's lawn when I was a kid in my car. I stayed out way too late. I've done stupid stuff when I was 20. We've all done stupid stuff when we were 20.
There's stupid stuff and there's just admit you're a plushie. Now my other question is, of the animals on the frozen display.
Yeah.
You didn't pick Elsa.
No.
Didn't pick Anna. Didn't pick Sven.
No.
Didn't even pick the fucking reindeer.
Nope.
He went for no actual warm mammal.
Nope, went for Olaf. Yep.
Went for the snowman.
And then a unicorn.
And then a unicorn. Who's that guy from Suicide Squad?
It's not Suicide Squad, it's Deadpool.
No, there was a guy with Suicide Squad who had a unicorn. It was a thing. The loud Australian one.
Well, I didn't actually see the movie because it was terrible.
Well, how do you know it was terrible if you didn't see it?
Because I can read a review, and I can see a trailer.
Oh, Captain Boomerang.
Yeah.
Ah. See, that alone tells me it's terrible, because I know Captain Boomerang, and stuffed unicorns have nothing to do with Captain. Anyway.
He'll be back for the new one.
And I still won't see it. All right. In any event, this does not count as stupid stuff.
No.
This is horrible. What you have done.
You are fetish. And that's fine.
Yeah, it's just...
You gotta buy your own stuffed animals to jizz on.
Right? And you don't get to share with everybody. Unless everybody's cool with it.
Simba likes to hump his little Chewbacca mouse.
He does.
Or rather, he likes to hump the bed with his Chewbacca mouse in his mouth. And that's fine.
Do you have to share this about your poor cats?
He's somewhere like, Mom! So embarrassing!
The worst thing is, at first we thought it was just him being cute, marching in place and holding his baby, and then noticed he was like dry humping.
Then we noticed the little hip movement going on. And we were like, oh
God.
He's having special time.
Do you have to share?
Yes. What's the name of the show?
Okay. All right.
He has emotional problems.
Well,
at least he got his own Chewbacca mouse.
Right.
Well, let's go from one magical world of Disney to another.
Sounds like Simba needs to be spayed. Well, he's a boy.
Yeah, that.
But he was neutered.
Yes.
I don't think you could. That, how would.
You can't spay a boy.
No. All right. Let's move on to this one.
Some neutered male still hump stuff. It's a thing.
Hello, Florida. Ex-Disney employee accused of stealing $14,000 worth of costumes from Walt Disney World. And that picture, that is.
Oh, honey.
Yeah. That's off his own cell phone, by the way.
That's what, like, two costumes?
When Patrick Spice was brought in by law enforcement for questioning, he didn't want investigators to see his phone. The reason why? According to detectives, the smartphone he didn't want to give up was used to take pictures of costumes and props they say he stole from Walt Disney World. Orange County Sheriff's Office says Spikes is a former Disney employee. He used his ID badge to get behind-the-scenes access to the park, then he'd take the backstage photos he would upload to his Twitter account called Backdoor Disney. Back in 2018, Disney reported animatronic was stolen from Epcot. It was later discovered costumes of the Haunted Mansion and other attractions. Deputies say Spikes and his cousin, Blayton Taunton, stole...
Blayton?
Blayton. That's a white person name if I ever saw one. Aaron! Blayton Taunton. That is spelled B-L-A-Y-T-I-N. Stole the items and have the pictures to prove it. Todd even created a fake name and ID. They're going to find you.
Yeah.
It's not like they're going to be like, who could have possibly done this? And you'd be like, they'll never know it was me. They'll know it was you. You fucking worked there.
There's cameras everywhere. Shit,
you're on a fucking list.
Yeah. It's a fucking compound, man.
No shit. I just, what?
You stole an animatronic? How did you even get that out of the park?
And I love that he was carrying around all the pictures on his phone. You have evidence. That's what we call admissible evidence, you idiot.
Yeah.
That's very easy to, I mean, for frick's sake.
Not exactly Ocean's 11 here.
Why would you, why? Why?
Oh my God, that would be a great parody. Mickey's 11.
He had a Twitter account called Backdoor Disney.
That sounds dirtier than I think it probably is.
It does, yeah. Doesn't it? It's
like that conjures some unsettling images of Disney princesses.
That's another thing. They're going to find you because it's called an IP address, and Twitter will happily give your information over to law enforcement.
Oh yeah.
They're not standing for you. Twitter's not going to be like, oh no, we won't give his information over. We love him. We love Patrick Spikes. We're keeping his stuff.
They won't do that unless you're the president.
Right. And then you have to be really, really racist.
And even then, they'll protect you.
Oh. Yeah, just everybody this week doing stupid shit. Well, I guess that's kind of the show.
That's our oeuvre.
Just the randomness of it is just killing me this week. Kansas Kansas man in custody after construction equipment joyride. Yeah, he's not looking in great shape there, is he?
Oh, wow. I mean, there's not much else to do in Kansas, as I understand it.
No, it really isn't. Oh, it's Topeka.
Topeka. Yeah. A man in custody after officials say he rode down a Topeka street in a stolen excavator, leaving houses with property damage and endangering officers. Topeka police say 46-year-old Shane Funk.
Really?
Man, okay, look, if I was born with the name Funk, I could have made a career out of that shit by now.
Like, why are you not a white rapper?
Why? Just, you could do so much. You were born with, that was gold. You were handed Shane gold, Funk. Shane.
And what you're doing with that magical name is stealing excavators.
Driving a stolen piece of machinery in the Oakland neighborhood, when officers arrived at the scene, they urged him to stop the excavator. Instead, he waved the loader at them. Officers then used rubber devices to keep Funk from operating the excavator. I want to clarify this for my foreign viewers. When they say rubber devices, they mean non-lethal bullets.
Oh, okay. Because I was like, I'd like a little more clarification in there.
No, Tara, they weren't like hurling dildos.
I was thinking, were they putting condoms over the tongs on the excavator?
No, rubber devices are, that is non-lethal ammunition. That's probably why he looks like that.
That's a hell of a euphemism.
Officers officers evacuated residents in the excavator's path to prevent any harm to people who lived in the area. When the police show up and they're like, sir, get down from the excavator, don't wave the heavy machinery at them. That's threatening.
I should know this because my dad drove one, but how fast can an excavator even go?
Maybe 30 miles an hour, if that.
So it wasn't exactly a high-speed chase.
No. If these things can go 30 miles an hour, I would be astonished. Maybe someone in the channel knows.
Like, I know they have to move them from site to site, but they're not built for fucking street racing. Like, they're really heavy.
Of all the things that Cascade Will says, sir, get down for the excavator. No, you're going to yell at me.
Oh, Shane Funk.
How fast can these things go? Because I'm thinking 30 miles, I'm thinking that's probably generous. Does anyone know? Has anyone ever dealt with an excavator?
Like, my dad used to give us rides in the front thing, but we never actually, top speed usually is 23 miles an hour.
Yep.
So like, you're going to die in 5 minutes.
Exactly. Exactly. Yes. Are you really that bored, Shane? There was nothing else to do?
I mean, he is in Kansas.
Kansas.
Yeah, but you could get Hulu or something.
Like, he's from there. And look how he turned out. Am I wrong? Are you normal?
Yeah, but it's not because of Kansas.
Okay.
Got a story here from Philadelphia where stupidity actually helped the situation. I know, it's amazing. Police, Boost Mobile employee in Fairhill stops armed robbery, traps suspect inside store. Philadelphia police say a quick-thinking employee stopped an armed robbery and locked the suspect inside the store until police arrived. The employee says a man pulled a gun and demanded money. The employee told him he had to, quote, go outside to get the money. Kent, quote, can you wait a few minutes? I'll give you money. I have another employee outside. He took the key, but after that, I'll give you, recounts the employee, and he told me okay. He then shut the door and locked it from outside, trapping the suspect. Okay. Okay, but you better not be fooling. I'll be standing right here. Although I will tell you that the dude was pushing it because they did not have bulletproof glass. Dude shot some holes through, like, I'll shoot you. Like, yeah, I can just get down on the ground. I'm fine.
I mean, that's a quick thinking employee. No, wait, I just have to go get it.
Yeah, I'll get you your money. I just have to go outside. All right, no funny business.
Watch the store for me. Oh, they're like, I'm mean to Dan. First of all, where have you been?
Right.
Second, he knows I'm joking and then I love him. Third, he's not normal. He married me.
And it is Kansas.
If you're that dumb and you want to go into crime, maybe you should get someone else to do the thinking part.
You should get a partner.
Right.
To do the planning.
Because you are definitely the Lenny in this situation.
Oh, no.
You need a George. You need a George. Just, oh, good God. I mean, you're saying this is a repeat. This is not a repeat. This is October 23rd, 2019. Yeah, this just happened. This freaking just happened.
19-year-old suspect. Fucking kid, man.
Well, it's not like he was gonna pass an SAT. I'm just saying.
No, you can be book smart and have like shitty common sense. Like, my sister had a friend who was an honor student, National Honor Society and everything, and she would call us and be like, "Hi, are you home?" She did that more than once. No, we left.
There's a lack of common sense, and then there's just being plug stupid, and not. I mean, if you're the basics of crime, you did not understand the basics of the crime.
No, I'm just gonna go get the money. You stay here, watch the store for me.
I mean, I really don't think this guy's gonna be able to solve word problems. Do you? Just saying. All right, finally this week, we got video, and this is a whole bunch of bless your stupid heart. Oh, Lordy. Let me get the video up here for everybody. You can go ahead and start watching it yourself. Let's see. It is, yeah, here it is. And this comes from
Michigan.
Here we go. Have a look.
Video, why you no play?
Man who attempted to spin his brand new tires lost control and crashed into a Michigan gas station before fleeing the scene on Thursday. Video shows William Edmonds, 24, accelerating the parking lot of an Ortonville BP gas station before his truck hit the gas pump island and crashes into the convenience store. He told police he wanted to spin his wheels around 180 degrees. Glass, plastic shelving, wine bottles. Now, here's the best part. You can watch him do it right now. The dazed man, whose truck stopped in the middle of the store, can then be seen attempting to detach his license plate and falling down on the debris litter floor as he rips it from the truck. He then pulls up his sagging pants and walks out of the store past the skid marks of his pickup that were left in the outline. No one was injured.
They ripped off those license plates because, as we all know, gas stations don't have cameras.
Yeah, they'll never find him now. Oh, wait.
I thought you didn't use a credit card to buy your gas.
Wait, it's better. An employee recognized Edmonds as a regular customer.
Oh, my God.
He told police before the crash the suspect bought a beer and opened it before entering his vehicle. After his arrest, he told officers he had just gotten new tires and wanted to speed around the pumps when he lost control of his pickup truck. Edmonds then told him he'd been drinking beer and didn't mean to hit the building. He added he ripped off his license plate after getting scared following the crash.
But he only ripped off the back one. There's one on the front too, you fucking moron.
Actually, depending on what state you are, there's only one on the back.
Really?
South Carolina only has the one on the back.
Everywhere yeah. I've lived, like the one on the front, they actually take more seriously.
Oh yeah, it's when I was in Illinois, had one on the front, one on the back. Here in South Carolina,
New York, they don't care if your back one falls off, but if the front one falls off, you get a ticket.
Weird, but
yeah, I never really understood it because that's not. I don't know.
Yeah,
Was he trying to do a donut around the pumps?
I guess.
Why?
I don't know.
I mean, obviously he's an idiot.
Oh, look at that mess. Just, my God.
That's somebody has to clean that up, and they make $9 an hour if they're lucky.
That's amazing. Holy shit.
The sight of him ripping off his license plate. They'll never catch me.
I want to point out, he did this before he knew anyone was okay or not. There's no way he could know he hadn't possibly hurt someone. Yeah.
That someone wasn't under that truck.
Oh my God, you dick. I don't even understand what he was trying to accomplish here. I got new tires. Let's test them. Well,
let's ruin them.
Yeah, you did that. You can see your tread marks there on the freaking floor. Ah, my God. And you could see his face clearly in the video. For fuck's sake, yeah. You idiot.
Like, he didn't even check where the cameras are.
Although, you know what?
He didn't even pull up the hood on his hoodie.
Is it,
like, make a little fucking effort.
Is it weird that I can tell that entire stack there is 5-hour energy?
The big red mess?
Yeah, that's all 5-hour energy. I know that's a 5-hour energy display. I recognize it. Oh, okay. I guess the first thing we learned is what?
Idiot.
Yes. First thing we learned this week is the place to try out your new tires is on a closed track.
Yeah. Or an empty parking lot.
You can go to the freaking go to the freaking mall on a Sunday morning. Nobody's there. That's where every that is in America, the classic place every teenager learns to drive is the mall on a Sunday morning.
I learned at the state park.
You learned at the state park?
Yeah. We had a state park that had a lot of little private roadways and parking lots.
I learned at the mall. Sunday morning. Nobody was there. So yeah, we learned this week, you must be this smart to accomplish crime.
just keep learning.
Yeah. We've learned there's nothing to do in Kansas.
No.
It's just, there is nothing.
Unless you take up hunting monsters, saving people hunting things.
We have learned that we've learned not to fuck with the mouse. He will find you.
The mouse doesn't play.
No, it does not play. We've learned that sometimes you have to let it go, but not in the middle of a target.
No.
Don't do that. And finally, we've learned that just because you get yourself all the accoutrements and accessories does not mean you actually are the cop.
No.
It's not like that episode of Buffy with the magical costumes.